sample problem 27.01. The EMFs and the resistances in the circuit of the figure have the following values. The EMF of the first battery is 4.4 volt and the second battery EMF is 2.1 volt and R1 and R2. That means both R1 and R2 are the internal resistance which takes the value of 2.3 ohm and 1.8 ohm respectively. And the external resistance caps R takes the value of 5.5 ohm. What is the current in the circuit? As we already worked out many problems in the previous videos, again in this question, first you have to see the circuit figure and then you have to apply the loop rule. So what is given in the circuit diagram? So in this circuit, they give the battery 1 with the internal resistance R1 and battery 2 with the internal resistance R2, and then we connected one external resistance outwards. So now if you see the value of the battery, the first battery EMF is stronger. So what I have to do, I have to consider the direction of the current like this as mentioned in the figure. So you can see the direction of the current. So the current will be going here and it will be entering the R2, and then again it will, the same current will be entering R, and then the same current will be entering R1 also. Now I have to apply the loop rule. What we studied in the loop rule, we studied the algebraic sum of the EMF, which is equal to the algebraic sum of the product of resistance and its respective current. So one side I am going to separate the battery EMF and other side I am going to take the product of the current and its resistance. Clear? Okay, let's see it. So battery, first one is the stronger. So according to the values they given in the question, the first battery EMF is a stronger, which one is 4.4 volt and the second one is 2.1 volt. So I have to write the equation as the EMF 1 minus EMF 2. Why? Because you can see this red arrow. So this arrow is against this. So that means we have to give the priority for the current, which is start from battery 1, which is equal to, and that current, the current from the battery 1 entering R2. So I have to write I multiply by R2, and the same current is entering R, plus I multiply by with external resistance R, and the same current is entering this R1. So I have right I multiply by R1. So here the current is the common. So I can take current I, which is multiply with R2 plus R plus R1, left hand side EMF 1 minus EMF 2. We are going to find the value of this current I. So I have to rearrange this equation. Therefore, the current I, which is equal to EMF 1 minus EMF 2 divided with R2 plus R plus R1, and all the values are given here. What is the value of EMF 1? So EMF 1 is 4.4 volt and EMF 2 is 2.1 volt. And then R1 takes the value of 2.3 ohm and R2, which is equal to 1.8 ohm. And the external resistance R takes the value of 5.5 ohm. And all these values I just simply take from the information which is provided in the question. Clear? So now I am going to substitute all the values here. So let's see what is the answer. So the current I, which is equal to 4.4 minus 2.1. I simply substitute all the values in this equation. So 4.4 minus 2.1 divided with 2.3 is for R2, so 2.3 for R1, so this is for R1, okay, so R1 plus, what is the value of R2, which is 1.8, so this is R2 plus the R value, what is the value, 5.5, so this is for R, clear, so I will just rewrite this one more time because this is a little bit, it not looks that much good, so I will just write according to the values, so 4.4 minus 2.1. So I'm going to add all this. So let's see what is the value in the denominator. So 2.3 plus 1.8 plus 5.5. I got the answer here as 9.6. So in the bottom, I got 9.6, which is equal to I. So let's see what is the value. So 4.4 minus 2.1 divided by 9.6. So here, the current value I got is 0.239. So what is the value of the current? 0.239, and the unit is ampere. So this is the answer for the first question. So I which is equal to 0.239 ampere. Okay, so now we have to answer the second question. So for this, better I can just take the circuit diagram, because we need that one. What is the potential difference between the terminals of the battery one? So if you see the circuit, so we have two points. We are just going to find what is the potential difference, the voltage across the EMF of the first battery. So we have two points, point A and point B. So in this place, we are going to find what should be the potential. So generally, the potential across the point A and B, which is given as VAB, which is equal to, we have to just write the apply the rule. What is the rule? We already know for this part, I am going to apply the loop rule. So what is the loop rule? E1, which is equal to I multiplied by R1, right? So therefore, E1 minus I multiplied by R1, which is equal to zero. And this is equal to voltage across A and B. So I have to take this value and I'm going to substitute here. So EMF of the first battery minus I multiplied by R1. So let's we see. So here VAB, we are just going to find. So VAB is nothing but VB minus VA or VA minus VB. You can just write, no problem. But now I am going to substitute the value. So what is the value of the first battery? The value of the first battery is given in the question as 4.4 volt. So I am going to use this value. So 4.4 volt multiplied. It's not multiplied. It's just 4.4 volt minus. What is the current? In the first part, we got the current here as 0.239 multiply with R1. What is the value of the R1? In the question, they clearly give the value of the R1 as 2.3 ohm. So 0.239 multiply with 2.3. So let's see what is the potential across this point A and B. So 4.4 minus 0.239 multiply with 2.3. I got the answer here as 3.85. So what's the value here? The potential across the point A and B, which is equal to 3.85 volt. So this is the answer for the second part. So here I just consider only this part. Clear? Only I just consider this part. So we just find what is the potential between the point A and B. So they clearly give the information in the question. So read this very carefully. Okay. So what is the potential difference between the terminal of the first battery? So this is the answer for the second part. That's it. Thank you.